Ambeth Rajan. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
आपने भाषण खत्म कर दिया.
Honorable Chairman, sir. I am very thankful to my party leader, National President Kumari Mayawati ji, for giving me an opportunity to participate in the discussion on this bill. I am also very thankful to Chair for pretending me to take part in the participation. I also congratulate Madam Minister for having hat-trick. Because this will be the third bill which will be passed now, today. It must be passed. I hope so. Madam, in the statement of objections recent, it has been stated that the School of Planning and Architecture, New Delhi, is a premier institution in the field of planning and architecture. It was established in 1959 as an autonomous society, registered under the Society Registration Act 1980. In 1979, the school was conferred with the status of deemed university. Madam, I will have one question. Since 1959, the School of Planning and Architecture is functioning. 55 academic years have passed. All these 55 years, students got admitted, studied, and got degrees. Whether during these 55 years, reservation in admission was followed or not. I would like to have clarification from the minister regarding this. And I also expect details of SCST students who have admitted particular students in the school. All the 55 years?
Whether you are following the reservation policy.
Yes. I presume the school in Vijayawada and Madhya Pradesh, which were established in 2008, would have hardly followed the reservation policy. Madam, I would like to bring to your notice that when our party leader and National President Kumari Mayawati ji was CM of Uttar Pradesh, Gautam Buddha University, which has a unique architecture, was established in Uttar Pradesh. That time, the reservation policy was adopted correctly in students' admission, faculty recruitment, and all other recruitments. I would like to add one more point, as our colleague from Tamil Nadu spoke about Mahabalipuram, Srirangam, and many places. What's Mahabalipuram, one and this? I request Madam Minister to visit Lucknow and see yourself the grand world-class architecture design which will find place in the grand monuments like Dr. Ambedkar Smarak, Manyavarshi Kansharam Smarak, Bursal, etc., which have been erected under the able and personal guidance and supervision of our leader, Benji Kumari Mayawati ji, during her last tenure when she was the Chief Minister of Uttar Pradesh. Madam, having said this, now I come to section 12. The section states that a board of governors and the Senate will be authorities of the schools. There in these 12 classes in section 13.2 deals with the composition of the board of governors. In these 12 classes, there is no mention about schedule caste and schedule tribe. Sir, I will complete, sir. Only 2 points. I will complete.
Sir, bhai, ye samay mere ko jitna diya hai, utna hi tumhe kya kya sakta hoon. सती जी
और आपसे एक 3 मिनट के समय में अगर 1 मिनट अभी क्रॉस भी नहीं हुआ है आपकी घंटी बज गई
श्रीमान
यहाँ ये तो उचित नहीं है मान्यवर मैं आपसे सम्मान के साथ
मुझे हिदायत दी गई है कि जो समय दिया गया है उसी में खत्म करना है
तो इसको आप 2 मिनट का सबर कर लिया आधे मिनट का सबर कर लिया
सबर मेरे पास तो बहुत है मुझे कहाँ कमी है केवल 2 मिनट का समय इनके पास है मैं क्या कर सकता हूँ किसी के लिए नहीं मेरे पास जो समय दिया गया है उसी पर मेरे को
सर इन
दो मिनट, केवल दो मिनट दिया गया है।
ना आई विल फिनिश इट, डोंट वरी। वो कंटिन्यू हटाना पड़ेगा सर। इन दिस 12 क्लासेस देयर इज नो मेंशन अबाउट शेड्यूल कास्ट एंड शेड्यूल ट्राइब। This is totally against the spirit of our constitution. Senate. The same in the case of section 16, which it deals with the Senate. There are also no mention about reservation, representation of SCST in the Senate, sir. Council. Section 33 deals about establishment of council. It also says about the combination of the council. It includes all those who are closely connected with the planning, architecture and construction. It is a very good step. But here also, SCST representation is nil. Dr. Ambedkar, architect of Indian Constitution, always thought of their upliftment and fought for reservation. Madam, please have a re-look at this section 12, 13 and 33. Then only people will look at you. Sir, there are various institutions, deemed university, which are offering BR courses across the country. Whether the council, which will be established under section 33 of the bill, will have power to exercise control over all those institutions which are offering BR. Sir, there is no need to have uniform, there is a need to have uniform syllabus pattern in India for the courses being offered. We are witnessing rapid urbanization. Wherever urbanization is taking place, we are facing many constraints. All these are happening because of lack of planning. Planning should be given top priority in the syllabus. Uniformity across the institution will ensure systematic planning in the country. I urge the minister to think over this aspect.
Ranjan ji, conclude kare, please.
Only one line. But don't press bill, sir. While government is planning to have institutions national importance, I request to take necessary steps to ensure national benefits. Why I am saying this? After becoming scholars, students are going after dollars. With this, I conclude my speech, sir. Thank you, sir.
Thank you.